Hello everyone. Today I'm going to show you how to use Shaft for parallel execution. If you're unfamiliar with Shaft, you can visit its GitHub page by following this URL or just googling Shaft underscore engine. Shaft is a unified test automation engine. It's a very powerful multi-layer wrapper built on top of Selenium, Appium, and other best-in-class test automation frameworks. Now, with the latest version of Shaft, you would be able to use parallel execution to run your tests in parallel and get more performance gains. And in order to demonstrate this feature, I've prepared this simple test class. In this test class, we have 10 test methods, all of which are identical, all of which calling the same reusable common steps method. And in this method, it just passes the first name and last name, where they get typed into a specific element, and then we validate that they've been typed correctly with this specific assertion. Now for this test class, we have different types of syntaxes for using Shaft. This is the older syntax, where you would just access the methods statically. This is the newer wizard-like syntax. It makes things faster and easier to use. Now, first of all, we're gonna clear our properties directory to make sure that we're using the default configuration, and then we're going to run the class. Our expectations here is that with the default configuration, Shaft should be able to identify that you're running on Windows operating system and that you want to use Chrome as your default browser. Those are, of course, the default settings for Shaft, but you can easily configure those from the configuration manager. The default configuration states that all the tests are going to run in sequence. So as you can see, it's running all of the 10 tests in sequence. And now this is the last one. Execution is finished and the execution report is going to open automatically. Here you can see that the execution duration was 22 seconds. If you open to view more information, you would be able to see the details for each one of those tests and make sure that the correct last name has been typed correctly with the proper underscore, which is relevant to the test method name, of course. For each one of them, you can see the assertion here and take a look at the screenshot, just to make sure that the correct last name was typed and it's not just something that's logged here as a message. Now this is the default. If we want to run in parallel, we can use Shaft Engine's Configuration Manager, navigate to the Parallelization tab, set Parallel Execution Mode to Methods, which ensures that all of the test methods will run in parallel inside multiple classes and your classes are going to run in sequence. And here we're going to configure the maximum number of parallel threads. For my setup, I'm going to set the maximum at 10 to make sure that I utilize the full capabilities of my device. Now, when I click on the button, it's going to download TestNG properties file. And as I can see here, that I need to move this file under this specific directory and override any existing one. I'm going to show it in folder, use cut, go back to my project, navigate to the properties directory, and then paste. Always make sure to replace the file and not rename it. After the file has been replaced successfully, I'm going to rerun the class. This time, it's going to read the configuration from the newly updated properties file, and it's going to try to run up to 10 threads in parallel. For my specific setup, that's not possible, so it's going to run 5x5. Now the execution is complete and the report is shown. As you can see, there's a 200% impact on performance as the numbers move down from 22 seconds to roughly 6 seconds. And if you navigate inside the report, you can make sure that everything is in order and all of the steps are still being logged here as you would expect to find them, as well as the screenshots that are relevant to the exact test method that you're running. Going back to the configuration manager, you can use it to change your platform, more details regarding web automation, mobile automation, your types of validations, and other configurations as well. And that's it. Thank you for using Shaft Engine.